Hello guys, my name is Prince and this is Smart Center. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Post your comments and questions on my social media handles and I'll respond to it. We are still on the topic plane geometry. In the previous video, we solved some questions using the properties of angles in a parallel line. In this video, we are going to consider the angle properties of triangles. You know that a triangle is a three-sided plane figure. So as we have in this diagram, we have the triangle ABC, then we have the angles M, N, and P. Now these angles M, N, and P are referred to as interior angles. They are the angles in the triangle. So they are being referred to as the interior angles of the triangle. Now, what is the property of this interior angle? The interior angles of a triangle sum up to 180 degrees. So if you add all the angles in a triangle, so here if you add M to N to P, you must get 180 degrees. This property is very, very important. The interior angles of a triangle sum up to 180 degrees. Let's consider another property of a triangle. In this slide here, we see that you consider the interior angle. Here, we have extended this line here, line AB, we've extended it to this side. Now we are creating another angle here. Remember, there's another one here, but for the sake of the explanation, we are going to use this angle here. I'm going to call this angle here S. S is an exterior angle. Remember, M, P, and N are called interior angles. S is an exterior angle. Now, this S here is called an exterior angle. P and N are called interior opposite angles of X. I'm going to explain that. P and N are called interior opposite angles of X. Now, let's look at this. M here is the interior angle of S. You see, on this line, M is the interior angle and S is the exterior angle. Now, what are the interior angles opposite to M? They are P and N. So we say that P and N here are the interior opposite angle of this exterior angle, which is S. How that is clear? P and N here, these angles, angle P and angle N, are the interior opposite angle of the exterior angle here, which is X. Because let's assume that we bring X here, which is the interior angle, we bring it to this side. You see, the angles that will be opposite to it are P and N. We are not bringing it here, it's an exterior angle. So we say that P and N are the interior opposite angles of X that we have here. Now, why am I stressing on this? There is this very, very important property that you know. So as I've indicated here, P and N are the interior opposite angles of X. So once again, let's say if we have another angle here, let's assume that we had another angle here. So let's say that we had another angle here, this exterior angle here, and let's call that one B. So if you call this B, we are going to say that M and P are the interior opposite angles of B. I hope that is clear. So M and P will be the interior opposite angles of B, because the interior angle of B is M and the ones opposite to it are P and N. So we say that M and P are the interior opposite angles of B. In the same way, if we extend this line so that I draw it for you to see. So in the same way, if we extend this line here and we create another angle here, and let's call it angle D. If you call this angle here angle D, sorry, My pen is not allowing me to write well. Okay. So if you call that the angle that you form here, if you call that angle angle D, if you call this angle the angle that we have, if you call it angle D, you are going to see that M and N will be the interior opposite angle of the angle that you form here, which will be angle D. I hope that is clear. So I'm going to erase the pen here so that we can continue. So here we say that P and N are the interior opposite angle of angle X, as we have here. Now in a triangle, an exterior angle is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles. I hope this is clear. So here the exterior angle, which is X, is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles. So here the interior opposite angles are P and N. So the exterior angle, which is X, is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles, which is P and N. I hope that is clear. So we've learned two properties here. We've learned that the interior angles of a triangle sum up to 180 degrees. We also learned that if you have an exterior angle in a triangle, it's equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles. I've explained what the where interior opposite angles mean. Let's pick some questions and see how to use the property that you just learned. So find the value of the letter in the diagrams below. So here you are supposed to find X and here you are supposed to find Y. Let's pick the first one. So we have A, B and C. So we have 70 degrees here. Here is X and here is 130 degrees. Now look at this very rule. We can see that we have 130 degrees here. Now, its interior opposite angles are X and 70 degrees. The exterior angle here, which is 130 degrees, its interior opposite angles are X and 70 degrees. We know that an exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles. So, 130 degrees is equal to 70 degrees plus X. If you simplify here, X is going to give us 60 degrees. So you see, it's that simple. This is a very easy way of doing this. Somebody can also pick another way. We know that 130 degrees and this side here, this particular side, I'm going to indicate that with a pen for you to see. 130 degrees and this angle here will be angles on a straight line. So somebody can use that and find the value of the angle that we have here. Now if the person finds the value of the angle that we have here, you can say that the sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So 70 degrees plus X plus that value will give us 180 degrees. Then you'll be able to find X. But this is easy. Always remember that. An exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles. So when you do that, you'll be able to find X here to be 60 degrees. Let's consider the next example. So here too, we can see that we have PQR as the triangle. Then we have Y here. Now looking at the position of the Y. Its interior opposite angles are 30 degrees and 40 degrees. We know that an exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles. So Y will give us 30 degrees plus 40 degrees and Y is 70 degrees. Thank you for watching this video on the angle properties of triangles. We are going to continue and learn more about the properties of triangles in the next video. Bye-bye.